And the other thing is that when you're passing the bobbin behind, if you do it with a pointer, then it's quite easy to pick up or light something. So yeah. Usually we kind of guard it with our hand and put it through blunt end first. So it goes through like that. So the bobbin stays in one hand. You don't have to sort of pass it from one hand to the other. The bobbin stays in one hand, and this hand deals with the warmth. Naomi beats down the hardest of all of us.
Yeah, I hear. She's really noisy.
Yeah. So you could hear
from down the street, actually.
Yeah. Whereas David is a lot more gentle. I think Douglas and me are somewhere in between. So, yeah, but the leashes do speed things in, especially if you're putting it.
Yeah, for longer.
So, you can.
Oh, very good.
Presumably it doesn't make a difference if you're right-handed or left-handed, or does it?
Well, no. It doesn't make a difference on the clock. It just, I guess you could just
swap hand each time, couldn't you?
You could do, yeah. I think it would probably slow you down a little bit if you're into your stride. So. Yep, so back warps.
Good. Well, I should probably do a bit of stitching here, shouldn't I?
Yeah, now the way that we do the stitching is that. Stitching.
You've knotted it, haven't you?
Yeah, because otherwise it'll fall off. That's quite handy, actually. Okay. You'd be coming into this village. What we do is the colour that we're stitching into.
Yeah.
It goes around the warp, so it's held securely.
Yeah.
The colour that we're weaving with gets sort of wrapped around the
web. Okay.
So. And that actually helps with the tension of where it joins onto the next colour as well. That just holding it tight like that. You can see that it's kind of doing the job there.
It is.
And so to complete the stitch, that's going around that wall. So that would be stitching every